بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. So there's a hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in Bukhari and Muslim. إذا دخل رمضان فتحت أبواب السماء, and in one riwayah, فتحت أبواب الجنة وغلقت أبواب جهنم وسلسلة الشياطين. This narration is in Bukhari and Muslim, the meaning of which is Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, he narrates that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, with the advent of Ramadan, the gates of the heaven are open, or like I mentioned in one narration, it's the gates of paradise, of Jannah, are opened, the gates of hell, Jahannam, are closed, shut, and the devils are chained up. So this is a Sahih hadith, and it often causes people a lot of confusion. Those suffering from black magic, evil eye, or jinn, etc., because of the last wording of the hadith, where it says that the shayateen, and it's plural as well, are chained up. So why is it then that a lot of people in the holy month of Ramadan, with so much mercy, blessings, and barakah descending, feel worse, i.e. that anxiety escalates, people get more angry, people argue more, particularly husband and wife, or whatever symptoms they have, they feel they are double, tripled, multiplied. So we have to look into the hadith first and foremost, because the hadith also applies to those who sin in Ramadan as well, that if the shayateen are chained up, why is it we still manage to sin? So the first meaning the ulama say is that only the big shayateen are chained up. The small ones, the minor ones, are still free. So hence people still sin because of the waswasa and influences of the small shayateen. And same with people who suffer from jinn, jadoo, black magic, etc. It's because the small ones are still free. They may be weaker, but they still have their capabilities. Another meaning, Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah, rahmatullah alayhi, in Majmul Fatawa, he explained that the shayateen are all chained up, but they are still able to send waswasa, and they are still able to make us sin. And in terms of black magic, jinn, jadoo, they still have certain capabilities, but it is weaker. They are not as strong when they are free and unchained. So Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah explains that even though they are chained, the effects of jinn jadoo, the effects of sinning are still there, but it's just weaker. Another reason, and this is not related to the hadith, that's the meaning of the hadith. Another reason is that many of us fast in Ramadan, those who need to, and it's fard on them. Fasting is a quick and easy way to burn black magic, to get rid of sihr, to burn jinn. And this is all year round. So if somebody wants a quick ilaj and treatment for black magic, then fast. Fast Monday, Thursday, fast the sunnah days, 3 days of every month. You can fast more if you need to, not just the sunnah days. Sawm-e Dawood, keeping a fast one day, missing a day, or just fast every day for a couple of weeks, couple of months, because fasting helps. So if fasting helps, then again, why do we feel worse? Those who have been through the treatment of ruqya or jinn jadoo, they will know in order for black magic to go, to be removed, we do feel worse for a few days, for a week or two. So in a way, it's a good sign. Sometimes symptoms are triggering off is a good sign that what's on you, your jinn, jadoo, whatever's around you is burning. Another reason is Quran. Many of us, mashallah, read Quran or more Quran in Ramadan. We finish at least one recitation of the whole Quran. Some do two, three. Those who are hafidh and hafidhas lead in Taraweeh as well. So all of this Quran is also burning your black magic, your jinn, your jadoo. So again, back to what I said, that you will feel worse. So it is because of the blessings of this month that sadly some of us will feel worse Maybe, and it doesn't last throughout the whole of Ramadan. I think it's unfair to say somebody has a bad Ramadan all 30 days. It's for usually the first few days. Some people feel in the last 10 days. But what we've got to understand, it is a good sign that what's on you is going. But what we always recommend, patience, is to do more. Read your manzil, read Surah Baqarah. Despite reading other Quran, a juz a day, a para a day, you have to still read your Surah Baqarah, Surah Rahman, Surah Taghabun, any surahs you are doing. And obviously keep using the other things which are good for you. But yeah, it is something which is noted every year that many people feel worse in Ramadan. Certain parts of Ramadan, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all shifa. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from evil eye, black magic. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroy those magicians and witches who perform this evil act, and give them the ability to do tawbah and return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And finally, may Allah give us the ability to make the most of this holy month. Jazakallah khair.